In this lecture, we will try to understand asymptotic notations. In order to understand asymptotic notations, first we will analyze what is growth function. In the context of growth function, log n dominates n, n dominates log n, n log n dominates n, n square dominates n log n, 2 power n dominates n square, n factorial dominates 2 power n, n power n dominates n factorial. This need not hold for all n. If it holds after some stage, it is enough for us. Now, what is the purpose of asymptotic notations? Purpose is to represent, basically it is a notation. This notation is useful to represent time complexity and space complexity of an algorithm. What are the commonly used asymptotic notations? First one is big O notation, second one is omega notation, third one is theta notation, fourth one is little O notation. We will try to understand one by one. First one, big O notation. Let f of n and g of n are two non-negative functions. Non-negative functions means what? F of n is greater than or equal to 0 and g of n is greater than or equal to 0. The function f of n equal to big O of g of n, if and only if there exist positive constants c and n naught such that f of n less than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. Means this inequality or f of n less than or equal to c into g of n need not hold for all n. If it holds after some stage, it is enough for me. Means here g of n is known as upper bound. This graphical representation of this particular notation we will discuss at the end of this lecture. We will try to understand this one with simple example. Let me consider f of n equal to 2n plus 3. 2n plus 3 can be written as 2n plus 3 less than or equal to 3n. Here we have 2n. Let me write instead of, anyway, n dominates 3. Therefore, instead of 2n, I am writing 3n. If I write 3n, I must check whether will it hold for which value of n. If I keep n equal to 1, 2 1s are 2 plus 3 5, 5 less than or equal to 3 1s are 3, 5 less than or equal to 3. It's not true. Let me check for n equal to 2, 2 2s are 4, 4 plus 3 7, 3 2s are 6, 7 less than or equal to 6. It's not true. Therefore, let me check with n equal to 3, 2 3 is 6, 6 plus 3 9, 9 less than or equal to n equal to 3, 3 3 is 9, 9 less than or equal to 9. It holds good for n equal to 3, even it holds good for n equal to 4, n equal to 5, n equal to 6, n equal to 10 crores. Means this inequality holds after n greater than or equal to 3. It is satisfying this definition, f of n less than, this is f of n, this is c, this is g of n. F of n less than or equal to c into g of n. Therefore, I can write it as f of n equal to big O of g of n. What is my f of n? 2n plus 3 equal to big O of g of n, c into g of n. Here g of n is n. Therefore, f of n equal to big O of g of n. Let me consider one more example. Let f of n equal to 10n square plus 4n plus 3. Here we have n square, n 3. According to growth function, certainly that n square will dominate other terms. Therefore, instead of 10n square, let me write less than or equal to 11n square. Let me substitute n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 like that. It will hold, if you check, if it will hold for all n greater than or equal to 5. Means 5, 6, 7, 8, 100, 1 lakh like that. Therefore, 10n square plus 4n less than or plus 3 less than or equal to 11n square holds good for all n greater than or equal to 5. Therefore, it is of the form f of n less than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught, here n naught equal to 5. Therefore, f of n equal to big O of g of n. Here g of n is n square, c is 11, f of n equal 10 n square plus 4 n plus 3. Therefore, I can express it as 10 n square f of n equal to big O of g of n. Here g of n equal to n square. Therefore, 10 n square plus 4 n plus 3 equal to big O of n square. This is second example. Let me consider one more example. This is example 3. F of n equal to 6 into 2 power n plus n square. If you observe this function, to according to growth function, certainly 2 power n dominates n square. Here we have 6 into 2 power n. Instead of 6 into 2 power n, let me write 7 into 2 power n. Again, if I check with trial and error method, it will hold for all n greater than or equal to 4. Therefore, it is of the form f of n less than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. Therefore, f of n equal to big O of g of n. Here f of n is 6 into 2 power n plus n square equal to big O of g of n. Here g of n is n. This is third example. Let me explain with one more example. This is simplest example. F of n equal to 3n plus 2. Here n dominates this number. Therefore, instead of 3n, if I write 4n, let me check with n equal to 1. 3 1 ja 3 plus 2 5. 5 less than or equal to 4 1 ja 4. It's not true. Let me try with n equal to 2. 3 2 ja 6. 6 plus 2 8. 8 less than or equal to 8, 4 to j 8. It holds for all n greater than or equal to 2. Therefore, f of n equal to big O of g of n. This is about big O notation. Now we will try to understand our second notation, omega notation. Here also, f of n and g of n are two non-negative functions. The function f of n equal to omega of g of n, if and only if there exist positive constants c and n naught such that f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. If you compare this definition with the previous definition, that is big O notation, instead of less than or equal to c into g of n, we have greater than or equal to c into g of n, isn't it? For all n greater than or equal to n naught. Let me consider one example. Example 1, f of n equal to 2n plus 3. 2n plus 3 can be written as greater than or equal to 2n. Why? Because this one is constant. If you substitute n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, so on, it holds for all n greater than or equal to 1. Therefore, it is of the form f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. Therefore, I can write it as f of n equal to omega of g of n. In similar manner, 10 n square plus 2 n plus 3, let it be f of n. In example, this is example 1, actually this is example 2. In example 2, I can write 10 n square plus 2 n plus 3 is greater than or equal to 10 n square. This dominating term is 10 n square. Anyway, we are getting 2 n plus 3 as an extra term, which will hold for all n greater than or equal to 1. This can be written as f of n equal to omega of g of n. Here we have a small correction. Instead of example 1, here I must write example 2. Now, theta notation. What is theta notation? Let f of n and g of n are two non-negative functions. The function f of n equal to theta of g of n, if and only if there exist positive constants c1, c2 and n naught such that c1 into g1, c1 into g of n less than or equal to f of n less than or equal to c2 into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. Let me consider one example. Let f of n equal to 2n plus 3. This can be written as, it must be expressed in the form of c1 into g of n less than or equal to f of n less than or equal to c2 into g of n. Therefore, I can write this 2n plus 3 as 2n less than or equal to 2n plus 3 less than or equal to 4n. If I apply trial and error method, it will hold good for all n greater than or equal to 2. Therefore, this is of the form c1 into g of n less than or equal to f of n less than or equal to c2 into g of n. Therefore, f of n equal to theta of g of n. Another example, you can understand this example with similar to first example. Our third notation is theta notation. What about our fourth notation? Fourth notation is little O notation. Let f of n be a non-negative function and g of n be a positive function. Here we are not allowing g of n be a non-negative function. If you allow, g of n may be greater than or equal to 0. Division by 0 is not allowed. Therefore, let me say g of n be a positive function. Then when can I say f of n equal to little o of g of n if and only if limit n goes to infinity f of n by g of n equal to 0. Let me consider f of n equal to 3 n plus 2. Which g of n I need if I take n square here n power 1. If I take n square, it's enough. Why? Because f of n by g of n, if you find limit of f of n by g of n, you'll get infinity by infinity form. Just take n common so that it will get cancelled. You'll get limit n goes to infinity f of n by g of n equal to 0. Therefore, I can say f of n equal to little of g of n means 3n plus 2 equal to little of g of n means n square. Even f of n by g of n, limit n goes to infinity f of n by g of n is equal to 0 for n cube, n power 4, n power 5 like that. But we need least power of n. Here least power of n is n square. Therefore, I am choosing g of n as n square. Therefore, limit n goes to infinity f of n by g of n is equal to 0. How can I represent these asymptotic notations with the help of graphs? Maybe there may be occasions where they may ask you to draw the graph for these particular notations. For example, let me consider this first notation. What is our first notation? Our first notation is what is our first notation? Is big O notation. How can I write big O notation? Means how can I write big O notation? What is the concept behind big O notation? Big O notation in the sense, big O notation in the sense, what it says according to definition, it says that big O notation graph. How can I represent this big O notation graph? Graphically, I can say like this. Let me say f of n less than or equal to c into g of n. Let me say this is my f of n. This is c into g of n. This f of n is less than or equal to c into g of n for all n greater than or equal to n naught. This can be treated as graph of big O notation. But whereas, what about another notation in the sense, after big O notation, we have omega notation. What is omega notation? Omega notation means, in the case of omega notation, how can I plot on the graph? In the case of omega notation, what we were saying, f of n is greater than or equal to c into g of n. This must be f of n, this must be c into g of n. Therefore, here g of n is lower bound. Whereas in the case of theta notation, how can I represent theta notation? Theta notation means, in the case of theta notation, condition is, well, how will it be? C1 into g of n. Let me say this one is c1 into g of n. This can be c2 into g of n. This may be f of n. Let me say like this. This is f of n. What does it mean? C1 into g of n less than or equal to f of n less than or equal to c2 into g of n. This can be treated as theta notation. Thank you.